Sifu Folly had this funny saying, when the hands go out, they better not come back empty. If your wife ever sends you out for an errand or chores or grocery, you better not come back home empty-handed. Quick, a change in your feet. Not up, but... That means whenever you're playing hands, the hand goes out, it better come back with something. A grab, a neck.
The first movement for plum flower leg,
second road,
is basically you're gonna retreat back or step back and then go into the tiger riding, okay? So this is kind of how it's all been done. You could do it this way, but I rethought it and I like to do it this way where you're not retreating back. It's more of a step back. The weight is still kind of on that front foot and you're just stepping back. Then you catch the block and then you can then pluck and kick at that moment. If the weight is going back, then your center is moving and it enables a person to trap you more. If you were to come and rush me and I step back, you have that advantage. I just feel like I'm in a state of running or
panic.
I'm having to play defense to try to get out of that. And not to say you can't do it, I think it's more work.
Dude, this, look, I sank.
And I catch you here, I still have this buffer.
Boom.
Right? Then I can then catch and then do my kick.
Whether you attack or not, I still attack. Whether the hand's there, I go there. If the hand's not there, but you just have it on guard, I still go here.
I'm really focused on the kick. This is just a distraction. All right, aim high, attack low, fake left, attack right.
When we look at it, it looks like an elbow strike, right? But the whole idea is a single whip. This is the whip, the whipping, but it looks like an elbow strike.
Sure.
Okay, one, two.
If I'm catching this as a break, if this hand is going up, then everything's going up at the same time.
Sure.
So I have to make sure this is staying down. But I think if I can keep it under control where you got the break, I get out of it and see how I still have my structure with this arch, then I can move to my next, and I think that's, to me, that's part of the Bong Sao.
Sure.
The Bong Sao is teaching you this circular structure where it becomes strong. If you're doing it like this, then the elbow's bent too much and you'll collapse.
Sure.
If you are too straight, well, you know, there's no leverage with that.
Sure.
But if you get the right arc and keep that structure, so then as soon as you catch that break and you're doing the break,
sir,
then I can go straight off that because I have the structure.
Yes, sir.
But if I go too loose, and now I have the next defense, which we just learned in empty hand versus double dagger. So that's what we're doing here, right?
Sir.
And so part of the Bong Sao, as you do the Bong Sao, so we got this, all these techniques wrapped up in the Bong Sao. So you got this break in here. To be mean, you go right on the joint to break it. To be nice, you're catching here.
Sir.
And then the Bong Sao, think about, I think there may be two applications. If I can catch the center, then I can catch the center with this technique. Or do I forget about the center and I just go and just boom, boom, or you know, ear. Or it could be a strike, right? But break, and then strike, right? Or boom, right?
Sure.
But if we're doing practicing in the form, I like to put the hand like this, because I don't know what's gonna happen next. I get Shulong, they've always done it like this.
so that the fingers aren't in the way. It can be argued on both sides, right? But my reasoning is here, if I'm doing like this, then if I have the hand, then I'm ready for a palm strike. If this, then I have to, it's a subtle argument, right?
Yeah.
Or if it were like this and I feel the energy going up, then I come in with the punch. So it all depends on when I'm here, do I go here or do I go here? Okay. So right, elbow strike, right, elbow strike. You're not focused on up, you're focused on quick changing of the feet. Not up, but. So there's times where it's just this single, and then this one I think they call Mandarin duck kicks, or the double. Flying kick, pop, pop. And then from there, pop, pop, boom. Making sure that you're structured in your rotation so that everything is getting addressed at some point. And then you forget it, and then you move on to the next thing, and then you revisit it again. And you forget it, and you keep working on it, and then you forget it, and then you work on it again. That's why I think the importance of the emphasis on the rotation is important. Here, single whip. Oh, so here we go. Here we go with the waist chop again. So, should it be up high, low, or is it like this? I think it may be depending on how you throw this, how you work this technique. Okay, and here, left, right. Here. Chipping palm, and then ending. It's a good one.